Have you ever noticed that sometimes the more you try to prepare for an exam by practicing old questions, the less effective your studying seems to become? This counterintuitive experience isn't just a common academic frustration. It reflects a critical and profound principle known as overfitting. Overfitting occurs when a model or theory becomes so finely tuned to specific samples that it fails to generalize to new, unseen situations. This concept is not only pivotal in data science and machine learning, but also offers valuable lessons for how we approach learning and making decisions in everyday life. Welcome to Luck by Numbers, where luck meets logic. Let's begin with this graph. Imagine we have collected the average temperature at various hours in a specific location and obtained some data points. Now, we aim to develop a model that can comprehend the underlying principles of temperature changes based on this data. How do we construct the model? The simplest approach is to fit a straight line. We can use a linear function to describe the relationship between input and output, providing temperature predictions for every second of the day. These red lines represent the deviations between the line and the data points. We identify the line with the smallest sum of squares of deviations, known as the least squares method. We use the sum of squares rather than just the sum to prevent positive and negative deviations from cancelling each other. In essence, we are trying to minimize the loss value L. On a technical note, the Bayesian predictor is the conditional expectation of the average temperature given the time of day if we use a sum of squared error loss function. We can examine the best fit straight line alongside these data points. Do you believe the relationship it depicts is accurate? It seems somewhat off. These points obviously exhibit fluctuations throughout the day. It shouldn't be a straight line. We can complicate the model by using a cubic polynomial. It fits the ups and downs quite well. But what if we increase the degree? As the polynomial's degree rises, our model becomes increasingly complex. You can observe that this curve aligns with the data points more effectively and the total deviation diminishes. However, when the degree reaches 12, something peculiar occurs. This 12th order function perfectly passes through all the data points, meaning the deviation is zero, a perfect fit. Yet, this flawless curve becomes distorted, entirely losing the simple and elegant shape of the wave, and significantly deviating from the true underlying principle. This phenomenon is overfitting. As the model increases in complexity, it aligns more closely with the historical data. However, when the complexity surpasses a certain point, it becomes counterproductive. The more accurately you fit the training data, the greater the deviation will be on new data. Indeed, the concept of curve fitting extends far beyond mere mathematical exercises. It has profound philosophical implications. Consider this: a child learning to differentiate between cats and dogs, a student preparing for exams by tackling practice questions, or a sports coach devising strategies by analyzing previous matches. They all essentially follow the same process. Data points reflect past experiences and scenarios, indicating the output corresponding to specific input conditions. Human intelligence must grasp the underlying principles derived from this data and then apply these principles to predict the outcomes of unfamiliar scenarios accurately. Therefore, overfitting implies that if there exists a highly complex and sophisticated theory that can explain all past data perfectly, it is very likely to be a flawed theory, much like a line that perfectly traverses all data points, yet remain exceedingly incorrect. But you may ask, why shouldn't the correct model pass through all the points perfectly? The answer lies in errors. Our measured data points are not exact, and if we fit a curve perfectly through all the points, it captures all the noise in our data. The model is overly sensitive to noise. If we slightly adjust two data points, you can see the shape of the curve changing drastically. On the other hand, if we use a much simpler cubic polynomial, the shape doesn't change much when we move the data points around. We will choose this simple model over a complicated 12th order model even when the loss value is higher. I'm certain you have come across these viral maths questions on social media. You are presented with some equations and asked to find a pattern. 7 equals to 128, 6 equals 64, 5 equals 32, then what is 3 equal to? The obvious answer here is the powers of 2, meaning 3 equals 8. However, why can't we set up a quadratic polynomial and fit the 3 points given to us? Then, f of 3 equals 64 is a valid answer as well. You may say, this answer seems absurd, but try to convince me, why can't 64 be the correct answer? If you think deeply, you will discover that the powers of 2 sequence is more straightforward by comparison. While I can always construct a polynomial to fit all the data points and solve these types of questions, you won't be satisfied. From this perspective, you can also understand another famous principle in philosophy and logic. Entities should not be multiplied beyond necessity. When multiple theories can explain the same phenomenon, we should choose the one with the least assumptions and the simplest one, because the simpler one is often closer to the truth. In our daily lives, we can find many examples of the human brain overfitting. One example is the Barnum effect. Have you heard of the MBTI personality test? This test, which categorizes individuals into one of 16 personality types based on their responses, often provides generic descriptions that many people feel apply specifically to them. It is a classic example of how easily we can overfit our interpretations to match broad and specific data when we believe it pertains uniquely to us. Stereotyping is another example. When we stereotype, we essentially create a mental model overly fitted to our limited observations or experiences. This model is then wrongly applied to all individuals within that group. For instance, if someone meets a few individuals from a particular city who are unfriendly, they might conclude that all people from that city are unfriendly. Finally, back to the introduction. Why do many individuals perform poorly in exams despite working through countless practice questions? In essence, their problem-solving model significantly overfits these practice questions. For instance, consider the question, discuss the causes of World War I, which appeared in your exercises. You may feel compelled to memorize all the points in the suggested answer, perhaps even word for word. However, when you sit for the actual exam and are asked how the alliances contributed to the war's outbreak, you may find yourself at a loss. The thought process is too closely aligned with the memorized answer, so that even a slight change in the input, in this case the exam question, renders your output incorrect. In mathematics, when you notice some related and similar details in the solutions, you may overfit your problem-solving model to those solutions. If you've practiced the product rule and the quotient rule of differentiation extensively, you may tend to use them whenever possible in exams, even when simpler methods exist. So how can we avoid overfitting? We introduce another concept, training and validation. We split our data points into the training set and the validation set, and train our model only on the training set. Afterwards, we introduce the validation set to see how well the model performs on unseen data and adjust the model accordingly. When studying for an exam, we can apply the same concept by dividing our practice problems into a training set and a validation set. Spend unlimited time on the training set to master the material, but use a mock exam as your validation set. The mock exam simulates actual test conditions and helps you assess whether your understanding generalizes beyond the specific problems you practiced. This approach ensures you're not just memorizing answers, but genuinely learning to apply your knowledge. In short, a deep understanding of overfitting provides you with an essential awareness in your comprehension of the world. You should not expect a perfect explanation of all data in history, as they contain randomness. Using a set of seemingly convincing theories to explain everything from the past is like self-righteous people who think they know it all. In reality, they all use overfitting functions to justify past data points. When you apply this set of theories to forecast the future, they often turn out to be absurdly incorrect. Do not fixate on an overly complex and sophisticated model, nor should you insist on perfectly explaining everything. You are watching Luck by Numbers. If you find this video inspiring, please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts in the comment section below.